love you all. Welcome all you lovers to the Florida Love Show. This is your love hour right before happy hour, sponsored by Florida Love. Join us each week as we spread love in the Florida community and transform the world with love. Now, back to spreading love.
This is for you, Kenny. It's the Florida Love Show. Paying love forward is the theme. It's the Florida Love Show, hosted by Kenny and his dream. Every special guest brings their love to the set, and the interview flies, it all comes alive, like a duet. He wears many hearts, so he has a very special side. In the Brooklyn Cafe, it's a big love buffet, with roses galore, and you are adored. Come take a bouquet.
Welcome to the Florida Love Show. So I'm so excited for this show. I have been waiting like a year to have Nicole Love, who is pure love, on this show, and her mom Penny to love her beautiful dad. And it's Nicole's granddad. And Bob is so special. I mean, I have been crying all week because I relate to him, because he loves Elvis. He's really cool, he's really fun, and he's so handsome. He's just such a beautiful man of love. And so I love him so much. So there's something I want to read. So Penny, I'm going to read something, okay? So when I looked at the website when your dad passed, you wrote something. So I'm going to read it because I started crying after I read it. Okay. Dad, so this is what Penny wrote on the website. Dad, Life will never be the same without you. Thank you for all you taught me about working hard, for being an honest person who stood up for what you believed in, for never giving up, even when things seemed hopeless at times. Thank you for instilling your love for music in me, especially your love for Elvis. Thank you for being my mom and my dad, and for the self-discipline and self-respect you taught me. Thank you for the over-the-top memories of racing around in your hot rod cars, motorcycles, and trucks. Thank you for teaching me how to ride horses, dirt bikes, snowmobiles, and how to drive everything from a unicycle to an 18-wheeler. Wow. Thank you for teaching me how to fix most of the above, for teaching me how to do auto body work, mechanical work, carpentry, electrical, and plumbing. Incredible. Most importantly, Dad, thank you for your love. Sorry. I always knew I was your Princess Penny Ann. I love you and will see you one day on the other side. Your loving daughter, Penny. June 16th, 2022. And he passed on June 7th, 2022. So when I read this, I just started crying. It's so beautiful. So what's it like when I read that, Penny?
It's emotional.
Yeah.
Very. My dad was great. Yeah. He was one of a kind, for sure.
Oh, that's so nice. This would be nice in your house.
Mm-hmm. Talk.
Where was this picture taken?
That was taken in
That was taken in
Albany
at the ice skating.
At the ice skating nationals, figure skating nationals, for the pre-Olympics. My daughter's a figure skater, my other daughter.
Which one was a skater?
My younger daughter.
Was a figure skater?
She is.
Julia?
Yeah.
So I took him to the show.
Talking about crazy coincidences. Now we know God is spreading love and Bob is spreading love all over the world.
So cute. Yeah.
There's a zillion names. So your daughter, Julia. At the Figure Skating Nationals.
In New York, yeah.
Wow.
That was right before the Olympics.
Wow. He is so handsome. You are so beautiful. This is so gorgeous. So I want to show you a few other things.
Oh, boy.
Is that Julia?
Yes.
Aww.
Who's the beautiful woman
sweet.
On the other side?
It's Nicole.
That's Nicole. Look how beautiful Nicole is. Where was this taken?
That was on Mother's Day. That was the last time we all got together, actually, for dinner.
Yeah, that was Mother's Day. We took my dad to lunch.
At Carmine's.
This year.
Mm-hmm. That was the last time I saw him, I think. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that was the last time you saw him?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. Wow. Life is short. And unexpected, because he never expected he would pass.
No, so we always celebrated Mother's Day and Father's Day.
Mm-hmm.
So this was Mother's Day and Father's Day.
Well, he didn't make Father's Day this year.
This picture's so beautiful.
Bailey.
That's my dog. That was actually Nicole bought that dog for her little sister during COVID, the week COVID began.
Her birthday or Christmas? Her birthday.
Her birthday, yeah. The week COVID sprang on us.
Bailey. That's cute.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
My dad loved animals.
Yeah, well, I can tell. He's pure love. Look at this.
Yeah.
Yeah, he used to feed his horse carrots out of his mouth.
Really?
Yeah.
So he had his own horse?
Oh, he had horses his whole life.
Misty.
Wow.
Is the main horse. That's wow. so funny.
Yeah.
There's a lot of them. Is Your that house horse? Is gonna be
stacked. Oh, yeah. That's his horse.
What's his horse's name?
Misty.
Misty.
Is that Misty?
Misty, yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, that's so nice.
Isn't that your background?
I love that photo.
That's your background picture.
That's my screensaver.
Well, these are all my gifts to you.
Oh, thank your whole you. House is going to be...
These are all my gifts to you.
A wall for Bob Fisher.
I love all these photos of him.
Baxton.
I love it. They're printed so good.
They're so nice. Please?
That's so nice.
All right, when he's done.
Aw. Rodney's going to be like,
whoa. So this is also...
I don't have one picture of us.
Where you said, thank you for teaching me how to fix and all the love.
That's so nice.
Oh, that's nice.
That's really nice.
Here you go.
I can't hear you.
Oh,
well, I
love you, brother. Love you.
Aww.
So this is a little 50s diner that's out in Okeechobee that my dad used to love. So I used to take him there. That little car is actually like their Happy Meal box. So he would get that with chicken nuggets.
That's so cute.
That is so cute. He loved that place.
That place. He's the best. I love him so much.
Yeah. He loved that little place.
Look how much fun he is.
Oh, you can see people commenting too. That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So love you, Christine, and love you, CC. So people are sending love to you.
Thank you.
Hello, beautiful souls.
That's nice.
Beautiful Bob. I love him so much. Love him so much.
He's so great.
Aww.
Gosh, that's start a while crying. Ago.
Where was this taken?
New York. That was in New York.
When?
One of his birthdays. Probably, I want to think it's probably about 10 years ago.
It's that long ago?
Yeah, that one is.
Oh my goodness.
So one of his birthdays 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And his birthday's coming up, right, on the 15th?
16th
the
of
16th
October.
The 16th of
October. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So, like, he passed away on the 7th, and today's the 9th. So it's almost 2 months ago.
Like, I think three months ago.
3 months ago.
3 months ago. So the three-month passing anniversary.
Yep.
And you have his birthday coming up. And he's right here with us right now.
Well, he's actually in Graceland.
Well, he's in Graceland, which you'll tell me more about the ashes. Yeah, and he loved Elvis.
He loved Elvis.
Yeah, he loved Elvis.
He's so funny.
He loved Elvis.
Oh, yeah. That's my dad right there in a nutshell.
And I thought that was hilarious.
Elvis. Hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, where's this taken?
In New York.
He was young.
I took that photo about 30 years ago.
Wow.
And I have all his guitars. He loved guitars. Actually, you have one of his guitars, don't you?
No.
You, don't?
You have it.
Oh.
Wow.
Yeah. That's.
So how much did he love Elvis? What was the last song he was playing in his car?
Unchained Melody.
Yeah, blasting Unchained Melody, right?
Yeah.
So when you got into his car after he passed, he was blasting Unchained Melody.
Blasting it. I started it up and it was just, oh, very eerie.
Yeah. I love him so much.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah, that was Christmas last
year,
right?
Us. Yeah. That was his past one, yeah.
Yeah, that was last Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
That's my son, Chris, on the end.
That's your son on the right, on the end?
Yeah. Yeah.
That was a special Christmas. That was your last one with Dad.
I'm glad we took pictures of everything.
I am too.
You take a lot of pictures, but it just shows like why it's important to take pictures.
It is. I take a lot of pictures.
You don't know. Like,
I take a lot of random pictures of him.
Yeah.
He hated photos.
Well, these are all my gifts and love for you.
Thank you.
That's nice. Sweet.
I love you so much.
Those are really nice.
I love you, Dad.
They're really
Bob,
nice.
So much.
I can't wait to see where you put all of these. Aw.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Oh, my gosh. There's you.
Yeah.
Which one's you?
The one leaning on his
the
shoulder.
The little girl.
The little girl over there? She's adorable.
Thanks.
You're a real cutie. Precious.
That was, yeah, that was actually the day that my dad had custody of all of us after him and my mom got divorced.
Wow.
He picked us up and took us straight to the photo studio.
Wow. Well, that's a really special day. And it's so special, there was a reason why I made two of them. How do you like that?
Wow.
You have to give one to your brother when
that
he comes in town
incredible.
For Thanksgiving.
No accidents.
That he'd like
I'm
that.
I'm getting chills right now. I think Bob's talking to me.
We would.
And the parents says, don't stop the music.
But look at him. He, you know, that back then, we lived about 2.5 hours from New York City. And on the weekends, he would go to Studio 54, take disco lessons, because that was the big thing. John Travolta. I remember he taught me, for the fourth grade dance, I had to learn all the Donna Summer dances. He'd come home and then he'd teach us, and he loved to dance.
So there were no accidents, okay? So first thing, I told you my mom's name is Julia and your daughter's name is Julia.
Yeah.
Okay? My sister was a figure skater. We used to go to nationals all the time. My mom gave me figure skating lessons. I used to be able to do an axel.
Really?
Really. I went to nationals, Northeasterns. I'm right with you.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. My mom's dad passed when she was 4. She was put into an orphanage.
Wow.
So I understand what it's like to grow up.
Yeah, my dad was 4 too.
Yeah, so her mom was a mom and a dad.
Wow.
Yeah, he went back to Europe. He was killed in the Holocaust.
Wow.
Yeah, and my mom's an only child, so yeah.
Yeah, talk about parallels.
So I relate to everything you share so much.
Mm-hmm.
There were no accidents. God is love. This is like the most loving picture.
It is. I remember that day.
So two of these came out for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that'd be nice to give to your brother.
Yeah.
When he's in town.
This is a special day, and you, right, your brother, and he's coming down.
He's coming down for Thanksgiving.
Uh-huh. What's his name?
Bob.
Oh my
he's
God.
He's a junior.
Wow.
He's a junior.
Named after Dad, Bob Jr.
Mm-hmm.
Bob
wow.
Jr.
Well, I'm going to save the best picture for last.
Oh boy.
It's absolutely the best picture for last.
Oh boy.
You're going to have a whole.
Who's that little girl by the tow truck?
Is that you?
And that's I can't the even tow see truck it from that me. I.
Is that you in front of
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, no.
That sure is. Oh, that's great.
So cute.
That's hilarious.
So it says Bob's Auto Body Works, local and long distance.
Yeah. He's still out of transport for New York. But, yeah, I was his helper. I was the son that I guess, his favorite. Right? Definitely
yes.
I was a girl, but I was really
hands
like a
down.
Yeah, you were his favorite.
Jacking up cars at 4.
And Nicole's your favorite.
They're all my favorite.
We'll say that.
All my kids are my favorite.
For the show, we'll say that.
Well, she's
that.
Your favorite princess. Girl.
They all, you know what? They all have their own thing. Nicole was a vocal major in
okay.
school. She's
okay.
an amazing singer.
Okay.
And Christopher's my theater kid.
Okay.
Julia's the figure skater.
Wow.
So they're all very passionate about what they do.
But we're all very different personalities.
Yeah. But they're all funny.
Wow.
They're all quick-witted.
Yeah. And also yeah. Nicole's an entrepreneur like you, like Dad.
All of them. They're uh-huh. all gonna, they're all that way.
Uh-huh. So yeah. we have even more in common. So I was a singing lessons actor, model, everything, like your son, like Nicole. Mm-hmm. I used to sing.
Mm-hmm.
I sang Born Free in front of like 300 people when I was like 12 years old.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. You should have Nicole sing.
No.
Nicole, you want to sing?
Not today, but we'll She's plan incredible. It. We'll plan it.
Okay, great. We'll do that. So there were so many things. So my mom didn't have a dad, right? So she was an entrepreneur. So I just want to let you know how much I love you. So I just want to put up this one thing about karma. Because I believe the more love you put out, the more love you get back. So here's karma. What goes around comes around. Keep your circle positive, speak good words, think good thoughts, do good deeds. So I just want you to know how much I love you and thank you, because I have this game here that you gave me.
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell me about this beautiful game? I love this so much. Mwah. Mwah. 2020.
Mwah. That's so funny. I'm in the event business. That's what I do for a living. And then when COVID hit, my event business was shut down. So after, I guess, the whole March shut down around November, kids were all out of school. My son was home from college. And I just couldn't believe what was going on. I'm like, this is just crazy. It was just crazy that whole summer. All the stuff that was going on politically, the race stuff started. I mean, it's just crazy. So I go, you know, I'm going to make a game. This is so crazy this year. I'm going to make a game about it. So we sat down. I took a piece of thin plywood, drew it out, and just started writing down everything that we experienced in 2020 and made it into a game.
So you go around the board and you collect all the craziness of 2020.
So so you have to have the object of the game, right?
Uh-huh.
2020 was the big election year. Uh-huh. So the object of the game, each state of the United States is on the board. Each number of electoral votes that went with that state for the year 2020 is on that space. So as you roll the dice, the first person that collects 270 electoral votes wins the game.
Wow.
But you face all the challenges of 2020 in the process, from murder hornets that came into Washington, to COVID, mask things, lockdowns, wildfires, like everything. Everything was going on. It's like, this has just got to be a game.
Wow.
And that Christmas, so it took me like 6 months to design, development, and all that. So we just got them last year. I actually have 10,000 of them now.
So head to 2020-thegame.com.
It's on Amazon. Yeah, we have a website.
Okay.
But it's on Amazon. It's on
Walmart.
So
people want to go around the board and collect electoral votes and go through all the craziness.
It's just
it's a really fun game.
It's more of like a collector game. The game pieces are hilarious. All those images on the front, those are the game pieces.
Oh, my God.
So the COVID ball, toilet paper from the toilet paper shortage.
Oh, my God.
The donkey, the elephant, the
I'm
American
in love.
Flag, which is how you win the game.
Uh-huh.
It's
so
funny.
Everyone
funny.
Go and order the game. Support my mom.
Yeah, 2020-thegame.com.
Yeah, so 2020-thegame.com. Okay, so my mom created a game. She was an entrepreneur
really?
You called Dig-A-Rock. You go around the board, and she loves kids. So she wanted kids to learn how to collect rocks. They would collect gems and rocks, and she sold it to museums.
Wow.
Yeah. So when Nicole told me about the game, you and my mom and our whole family, I relate to everything.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Did you ever have a zebra? We had a zebra.
Yeah.
No, we really had a zebra.
He's like, yeah.
It's like,
yes.
What?
So I love you so much. I'm so excited for this game. So excited for this game. So
thank you.
I'm going to come back to loving dad in a big way, but I want to play two things. One, Queen Elizabeth just passed.
Yeah.
I want to love her right now and love everybody who's mourning her passing after 70 years of being the monarch of England and the Commonwealth. So can you please play the biography?
I often draw strength from meeting ordinary people doing extraordinary things.
Elizabeth was the longest-running monarch in British history. Mother to four children and grandmother to eight, she performed her public duties well into her 90s.
I still view her more as the queen than my grandmother. You have this huge amount of respect for your boss, and I always view her as my boss.
But royal life slowed down for the queen after she lost her beloved husband, Prince Philip, in April of 2021. The widowed monarch sat all alone at his pared-down pandemic funeral. The two had been married for 73 years.
For me, in the months since the death of my beloved Philip, I have drawn great comfort from the warmth and affection of the many tributes to his life and work.
The Queen carried on, but began to look frail and tired. In October of 2021, she spent a night in the hospital for an undisclosed ailment. Concerned for her health, Her Majesty's doctors ordered her to pause her public appearances and to rest. But determined to serve, in November of 2021, she made a video statement to world leaders at the Glasgow Climate Summit.
The impact of the environment on human progress was a subject close to the heart of my dear late husband.
After Philip's death, Elizabeth proved to be strong despite a number of challenges. In January of 2022, she stripped her son, Prince Andrew, of his HRH title and all of his military honors following his alleged involvement in the Jeffrey Epstein scandal and a related sexual assault lawsuit. The Queen also had to deal with the fallout from the Harry and Meghan Megxit drama.
I had three conversations with my grandmother and two conversations with my father. Before he stopped taking my calls.
From their bombshell sit-down with Oprah to the couple's constant legal battles with the press, the monarch publicly continued to voice support for the Sussex clan, who named their daughter Lilibet after the Queen's childhood nickname. Viewed by many as serious and old-fashioned, she was actually quite playful.
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister of Canada, for making me feel so old.
Good evening, Mr. Bond.
Good evening.
And remember this moment with Harry that quickly became a gif?
Hey, Prince Harry, remember when you told us to bring it at the Invictus Games?
Careful what you wish for. Boom.
Oh, really? Please.
Boom.
Elizabeth was known for her love of her corgis. Almost all of her outfits were custom-made just for her. In the 50s, she favored dresses cinched at the waist. In later years, she went for coats and hats, always in bright colors, so she could stand out in a crowd. The priceless jewels and tiaras she wore were historical family heirlooms. But what the Queen definitely valued was her family. She took great pleasure in attending the royal weddings of her grandsons, William with Kate and Harry to Meghan.
It's just been a busy year for my family, with two weddings and two babies and another child expected soon. It helps to keep a grandmother well occupied.
That was baby Archie, and the Queen appeared overjoyed when she met her new great-grandson for the first time. She beamed while watching Prince George make a Christmas pudding and seemed very proud watching Charlotte and Louis doing the royal wave. In fact, many have noticed that Princess Charlotte has a very strong resemblance to her great-granny.
The Queen, she was really thrilled that it was a little girl. And I think as soon as we came back here to Kensington, she was one of our first visitors here. I think she's very fond of Charlotte, always watching what she's up to. George calls her Gangan. She always leaves a little gift or something in their room when we go and stay, and that just shows, I think, her love for her family.
The Queen never sat down for a formal TV interview, but she did allow cameras into Buckingham Palace to record important events. On the 65th anniversary of her coronation, Her Majesty was quite cheeky when viewing the imperial state crown.
Once you put it on, it stays. And you can't look down to read the speech. You have to take the speech up. Because if you did, your neck would break. It would fall off.
But what many admired was the royal love story between Elizabeth and Prince Philip. The couple's romantic relationship and lavish wedding was depicted in the crown.
Hi, Elizabeth Alexandra Mary.
Take thee, Philip.
Take thee, Philip.
The two were supportive of each other and shared a love of the outdoors. The crown also portrayed their passion for riding, hiking, and silly parlor games.
Number four, ibble dibble with two dibble ibbles.
She had a long connection with Hollywood, giving some of the biggest stars titles, from Dame Elizabeth Taylor to Sir Paul McCartney and Sir Elton John. She made American citizen Angelina Jolie an honorary Dame of the British Empire for her work on behalf of refugees. And we love that she didn't seem fazed at all when she met Lady Gaga, who happened to be wearing a red rubber dress. And as the British people and millions around the world mourn Her Majesty, she will always be remembered as a woman who made and lived through history.
But even in the unlikeliest of places, hope can still be found.
Love you, Queen. Love you, Queen. Rest in peace. God save the Queen. So, I'm just going to read this. You never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory. Life is short, like life is now. I could pass right now on this show, right now. So that's why here we just love everyone. I say I love you to everyone. So today I'm also going to be loving 9/11. Anybody who was dealt with 9/11 in any which way. I happened to be in Manhattan that day. I saw it all happen. So I'm going to play you. This is a fascinating video from the traffic control on that day. Very emotional. Probably going to start crying. So please play the first video.
American 11, are you trying to call?
The cockpit is not answering their phone. Our number one has been staffed and our five has been staffed.
Hey, I'm going to call from Washington. I am in a situation with American 11, a possible hijack.
What's going on, Betty? The aircraft is erratic again. Problem, are you ready? Betty, talk to me. Betty, are you there? Betty? Betty? A plane just hit the road, right there.
What?
737?
Did what?
Like the World Trade Center.
Who are you talking to? Oh, God. Oh, my God.
United 175, New York. We have some problems over here right now. We might have a hijack over here, two of them.
Jules, this is Ryan. Listen, on an airplane that's been hijacked. If things don't go well, I'm looking good. I just want you to know I absolutely love you. I want you to do good. So happy to sign. Same to my parents and everybody. And I just totally love you. And I will see you in Denver. Bye, babe.
What are those people gonna do? All the elevators are blocked out.
Oh my God! So both towers are now.
Okay, Abby. I got an aircraft out east of the White House.
Hello.
Crystal City, just north of Crystal City.
Just to the north of your town.
Yeah. Stop all the parkers.
Pentagon just got hit. Don't throw in that. God damn, I can't even protect my NCA.
United 93, that traffic for you is 1 o'clock, 12 miles eastbound, 370.
Negative contact, we're looking at United 93.
Hey! United 93, Cleveland, if you hear the center, ident.
I got that piece of dock. Keep remaining sitting. You have a ball of hold.
Tuesday, 9:47 a.m.
Hi, baby. Baby, you have to listen to me carefully. I'm on a plane that's been hijacked. I'm on the plane. I'm calling from the plane. I want to tell you I love you. Please tell my children that I love them very much. And I'm so sorry, babe. I hope to be able to see your face again, baby. I love you. Bye.
We're 56865. We have I believe it is a Boeing 757. Can you see him up there, sir?
That's concurred. It looks like he's rocking his wings.
Roger.
He's rocking back and forth.
Number 56865, I advise you stay away from that aircraft. Go north as fast as you can.
United 93, have you got information on that yet?
Yeah, he's down.
He's down?
Yes.
When did he land?
He did not land.
Oh, he's down?
Yes,
down?
Somewhere up northeast of Camp David.
John, it's me. I just wanted to let you know I love you, and I'm stuck in this building in New York. There's lots of smoke, and I just wanted you to know that I love you always.
At number 2 World Trade Center, right? Maybe the speed is in the walking. We're not ready to die, but it's getting bad. Oh, God! Oh!
I'm gonna die.
Ma'am, say your prayers.
God.
We're gonna think positive because you gotta help each other get off the floor.
I'm dying.
It's a new type of war. That's what it is.
Wow. Whew, that's an emotional video. Life is short. I mean, a normal day, people going to work. A normal day. Bob, did you expect your dad to pass?
No.
No. Just a normal day.
We were in the Trade Center a week before that happened, up at Windows on the World. For her birthday, she was little. I took her up there with my son. When that happened, it was just crazy. It's very surreal.
Yeah, 3,000 people passed. And it was just a normal day.
I know. I was thinking, like, right after it happened, I hadn't even unpacked my luggage yet. And I was just thinking about all the people that we met up in the top that never made it down. That's awful.
Yeah.
Awful. Yeah, really awful. Really sad.
The world.
Yeah.
It's like one of my favorite restaurants. So life is short. That's why it's so important to love each other now. And again, like, you had no idea your dad was going to pass.
No.
No.
None.
So I'm just going to read something that my friend gave this to me, Alan Love, and it's about if you knew someone was going to pass, what would you do? Like, really, like now. So it's called If I Knew. If I knew it would be the last time that I'd see you fall asleep, I would tuck you in more tightly and pray the Lord your soul to keep. If I knew it would be the last time that I see you walk out the door, I would give you a hug and kiss and call you back for one more. If I knew it would be the last time I'd hear your voice lifted up in praise, I would videotape each action and word so I could play them back again day after day after day. If I knew it would be the last time I could spare an extra minute to stop and say I love you, instead of assuming you would just know that I do. If I knew it would be the last time I would be there to share your day, well, I'm sure you'll have so many more. So I could just let this one slip away, for surely there's always tomorrow to make up for an oversight. And we always get a second chance to make everything right. There will always be another day to say I love you. And certainly there's another chance to say our anything I can do, but just in case I'm wrong. And today is all I get. I'd like to say how much I love you. I love you. I love you all. And I hope we never forget. Tomorrow is not promised to anyone, young or old alike. And today may be the last chance you get to hold your loved one tight. So if you're waiting for tomorrow, yeah, why not do it today? That was so beautiful. For if tomorrow never comes, you'll surely regret the day that you didn't take that extra time for a smile, a hug, or a kiss. And you were too busy to grant someone what turned out to be their one last wish. So hold your loved ones close today. Hold your loved ones close today and whisper in their ear. Tell them how much you love them. Tell them how much you love them and that you'll always hold them dear. Take time to say, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you, or it's okay. And if tomorrow never comes, you'll have no regrets about today. Wow. So when you hear that, what's it like for you to hear that?
It's 100% true. You know, my dad, thank God, I don't have regrets about what I didn't do with him, especially the last few years when I moved him to Florida the last time. I made sure I, once a week, take him to lunch, made sure he, you know, I took him to the doctors and made sure he was in as best health as he could be in, even though it was totally unexpected, but like I'm okay with it. Like I don't have, thank God, I don't have regrets. Could have been, I could have had him, you know.
So if there was something that you'd love to say to your dad right now.
Oh, no, you don't.
What would you love to say?
Oh, no, you don't.
Yeah.
I love you. I love you, Dad. It's great.
You're gonna make me cry.
So I dedicated, I love you. I love you, Penny. Love you, Penny.
Love you too.
So I dedicated a few songs to you and Bob.
Oh God, oh, no. Here we go.
So please play the first song.
Today. Oh God.
It's gonna be the death of me today.
Well, I guess I wanted to put
you better hug me now before.
Thank you.
So that's a 6-year-old from the Philippines. When I saw that, I thought of you and I thought of Dad. Love you, Sharon. Love you, Sharon. Sharon sending her love. So what was it like to hear that song?
Well, so right after my dad passed, I didn't think I could ever listen to Elvis again. The thought of it was like, because I always listened to it. I grew up listening to him. But when I took my dad's ashes to Graceland, which was about a month after he passed, I went to the whole new Elvis place they built. Have you seen that yet? It's incredible. It's incredible. They have a museum basically for everything in his life, his cars, his outfits. They just got 100 of his 120 jumpsuits that they've gotten back into this collection. It is unbelievable. All of his, I mean, it's huge. You have to spend an entire day or more just to see it all. And they built it right across the street from Graceland. So I set it up with their corporate people to do their VIP tour. So I went up, spent 3 days there. I went up on a Friday, scheduled it for Saturday morning to go to the gravesite, scattered my dad's ashes. Then we went back for the 11 o'clock tour through Graceland. It was like a private tour. Then they took us into this room where they had some of his personal items, and we actually got to hold it, which was very cool. One of his guitars, his sunglasses, like his piano. Very, very cool. They give you gloves to put on, though. And so I was kind of, I did all this the same day because I really want, and then we did the tour, and as we did the end of the tour, we went past the end of it. You go past the grave sites again. So then I went to the museum and went through it all. And then I put Elvis on because this was an 18-day road trip. And my daughter lost her father in November last year. So part of the road trip was we went to see his family with my daughter. She got to see her grandmother. And we played Elvis the entire road trip. And I cried for probably half of it continuously just to try to desensitize myself to it, because I'm like, I don't want to not ever listen to it again because it's going to make me cry. I love the music and it makes me happy thinking of my dad. So I'm okay with it now. I've been playing it at my house even. But I was really terrified to even hear Elvis when it first happened. It's like, how am I ever going to do this? But it's okay.
Let me see that picture. I love this.
Yeah, I do too. I put that on his urn. And I had necklaces made of that that I have in my, they hang in my car on like a pendant. That's my dad.
So I love him so much. So I created a slideshow to let everybody know what an incredible, loving, handsome, beautiful man your dad is. Special. Special. Yeah. So can you please play the slideshow of Bob? Thank you. what's it like to see that slideshow and all those beautiful memories?
It's good. Some of it's funny. The one with the cups, you know, the shell game, right? So my dad's birthday. I don't know if you could tell from the picture. I balled up $100 bills. So my dad, because I was worried he was having cognitive issues, right? And he was, because he kept forgetting stuff and was writing notes all the time about things he was trying to remember. I'm like, is he getting dementia? So I took him to get tested and they said he was fine. I'm like, okay, well, but there's something off. Like, he's not remembering things. So I did this game with him because he would fight me on going to the doctor. I said, Dad, so I took a stack of $100 bills, balled them all up, and I put them under the cups. And I was doing this, where you slide them, he used to do it with me when I was a kid all the time. And then if you found it, you win the quarter or whatever it was. So he remembered where everyone was. It was the craziest thing ever. I was like trying to make, and his brain was, I was like, oh no, he's fine. He made like $1,000 that day. That was so funny. That was his birthday last year.
That's so funny.
It was so funny.
I mean, I saw those hundreds on the table.
It was all hundreds. It was
all crumpled up.
I balled them all up. I was like, I go, Dad, this is going to be a really fun game.
That's hilarious.
But that's the only way I could get him to play these little memory games with me. But he won. He won every one of them. I was like, okay, I'm broke. I'm going home.
So
I'm glad I had that time with him, mm-hmm. especially the last 3 years. Mm-hmm. When he moved back down here the last time. It's really important. Mm.
So I want you guys to hold each other tight. I'm going to play another song.
Oh, boy.
Okay, to love you.
Oh, boy.
Okay, sung by Beyonce.
Beyonce.
But
Beyonce.
It's special to your dad and all the love and memories that you had together with him.
I have used this to guilt my kids into hugging me more, though.
Okay, I was the one out there doing everything.
Oh.
Never forget it.
All right, well, you hold each other real tight. Love each other real tight. Love you, love you, love you. So please play the last song.
Choose to forget.
blessing to you, Ms. Carson. Thank you.
Beautiful. So what's it like to hear that?
Beautiful. She did a good job on it. James Brolin's smoking hot.
Did memories come up in your mind as she sang?
I hope she's not watching this.
Why?
I'm just kidding.
It's beautiful.
It's did really memories cute. Come up for you in your mind about Dad?
Barbara Streisand? No.
It was more feel good.
Yeah. Okay. Pretty song.
Okay. I love you so much, and I love Dad so much. So there was one song I saw that I just felt his presence when I saw it, and I want to play it for you because, I don't know, I felt like Dad created it. It was so beautiful. So can you play the song before this, please? Hunk a hunk of burning love.
Well, that car that is in the slideshow, that El Camino.
Yeah.
That was his legacy, that car. He drag raced that car. Built it. That car was my entire childhood. But that was black diamond tough leather interior. And that was the music. That's all that played in that car.
So before I end the show, what would you love to say to Dad?
Thank you.
I love you, Dad.
I really wish he was still here, but I love you, Dad. Happy birthday. His first heavenly birthday. That's going to be a rough one.
So I love you so much, Penny. I want to thank you for being on the Florida Love Show today.
Thank you for all of this. This is really sweet.
Love you, love you, love you.
Very, very nice.
Yeah, Nicole, I want to thank you too. Love you, love you, love you.
Thank you.
I love you, love you, love you.
Love you, love you, love you. Aww. So I want to thank all you lovers for watching the Florida Love Show today and commenting and loving Penny and Nicole and her dad, Bob. So I love you so much. We only have now to love each other. Life is short. I could pass right now. We all could pass right now. So let's all love each other. So as I end every show, who can you give a rose to? I love you.
You've been listening to the Florida Love Show, where we've been spreading love in the Florida community. For more information, please contact me, Penny Love, at 917-699-1995. Or Ken at florida-love.com or on our website, florida-love.com. See you next week, 3 p.m. Friday for the Friday Love Hour. Keep spreading love in your life and have a loving week. Love you all.